There's a giant bubble in space enveloping the sun and its planets. It was created by the sun's constant discharge of charged particles, or plasma, collectively known as the solar wind. This bubble is the edge of our solar system, and through the help of Voyager 1, scientists have discovered that something spooky and strange is occurring at this boundary. What could this new discovery be? How did Voyager 1 discover it? And how does this new discovery affect life on Earth? Keep watching this video till the end to find out. Humans have always been fascinated by the mysteries of space. Humankind has an insatiable need to learn new things, understand the truth behind myths and stories, and push themselves to new heights to unravel the enigma of outer space. Michael Minovich, an American mathematician, was the first to revolutionize spacecraft trajectories, redefining our understanding of how rocket-powered crafts could transit solar and interstellar space. Michael Minovich demonstrated that a spacecraft could steal velocity from a planet and utilize it to accelerate away from the sun. Gary Flandreau then took that rationale and showed that probes deployed in the late 1970s and early 1980s could benefit from a rare geometric alignment of the outer planets, jumping from world to world on gravitational arcs. To take a grand tour of the universe, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 were launched in 1977 into interstellar space, and it's been 45 years since the launch of U.S. interplanetary probes. They are still sending valuable data back to the scientists here on Earth. The Voyager program consisted of two spacecraft, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. Voyager 2 was launched first in August 1977, but Voyager 1 was sent on a faster trajectory when it was launched about 2 weeks later. They are the only two functioning spacecraft currently in interstellar space beyond the environment controlled by the sun. The Voyager mission arose from a happy accident of celestial mechanics, and it has served as the eyes of man and the universe for more time than was initially planned. The heliopause, as it is known in astronomical terms, is the boundary between the heliosphere, the bubble of solar wind encompassing the solar system, and the interstellar medium, the material between the stars. And it appears that this bubble is rippling and creating oblique angles in an unexpected manner. A scary discovery that was made possible by the Voyagers. The general concept that the heliopause changes shape is not new. Over the past decade, researchers have determined that it is not static. They made this discovery using data from Voyager 1 and Voyager 2, the only two spacecraft to exit the heliosphere thus far, as well as NASA's Interstellar Boundary Explorer, or IBEX, satellite, which studies the emissions of energetic neutral atoms, or ENAs, that are created when solar winds and the interstellar medium interact. Scientists have used the data to create models that predict how the heliopause changes. In a nutshell, solar winds and the interstellar medium push and pull on each other to create an ever-moving boundary. Furthermore, in reviewing data from the journeys of Voyager 1 and Voyager 2, the scientists discovered that the heliopause changed dramatically in a very short period of time. That helps to explain why there was such a large gap between the two probes' entrances into interstellar space, which happened in 2012 and 2018, respectively. But that isn't the only mystery involving the Voyagers. The classic 1979 sci-fi horror film, Alien, was advertised with the memorable tagline, "In space, no one can hear you scream." But it did not say anything about humming. Instruments aboard NASA's Voyager 1 spacecraft, which 10 years ago exited our solar system's outer reaches, have detected a faint, monotonous hum. Voyager 1, one of two sibling NASA spacecraft launched 45 years ago, and now the most distant human-made object in space, still works and zooms towards infinity. As the craft toils, it has long since zipped past the edge of the solar system through the heliopause, the solar system's border with interstellar space, into the interstellar medium. Due to Voyager's interstellar location, it takes light 20 years and 33 minutes to travel one way, so the call and response of one message between NASA and Voyager takes 2 days. So far, the Voyager team believes the Voyager computers are still working, but the instrument's data readouts seem random or impossible. The system issue hasn't triggered anything to put the spacecraft into safe mode yet. That's when only essential operations occur, so engineers can diagnose an issue that would put the spacecraft at risk. And Voyager's signal is as strong as ever, meaning the antenna is still pointed toward Earth. The team is trying to determine if this incorrect data is coming directly from this instrument or if another system is causing it. According to a NASA release, until the nature of the issue is better understood, the team cannot anticipate whether this might affect how long the spacecraft can collect and transmit science data. A mystery like this is sort of par for the course at this stage of the Voyager mission, said Suzanne Dodd, project manager for Voyager 1 and 2 at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, in a statement. The spacecraft are both almost 45 years old, which is far beyond what the mission planners anticipated. It's also an interstellar space, a high radiation environment that no spacecraft has flown in before. So there are bound to be some big challenges for the engineering team. If the team doesn't determine the source of the issue, they may just adapt to it. Or, if they can find it, the issue may be solved by making a software change or relying on a redundant hardware system. Voyager has already relied on backup systems to last as long as it has. In 2017, the probe fired thrusters that were used during its initial planetary encounters during the 1970s, and they still worked after remaining unused for 37 years. The aging probes produce very little power per year, so subsystems and heaters have been turned off over the years so that critical systems and science instruments can keep operating. Voyager 2, a twin spacecraft, continues to operate well in interstellar space, 12.1 billion miles from Earth. By comparison, Neptune, the farthest planet from Earth, is, at most, only 2.9 billion miles away. Both probes were launched in 1977 and have far exceeded their original purpose to fly by planets. Now, they have become the only two spacecraft to gather data from interstellar space and provide insights about the heliosphere, or the bubble created by the sun that extends beyond the planets in our solar system. And their journeys have been extraordinary. Only a year ago, Voyager 1's instruments had detected a constant drone of interstellar hum, caused by the constant vibrations of the small amounts of gas found in the near emptiness of interstellar space. It essentially represents the background noise present in the vast expanse between star systems. These vibrations, called persistent plasma waves, were identified at radio frequencies in a narrow bandwidth during a three-year period as Voyager 1 traverses interstellar space. The persistent plasma waves that we've just discovered are far too weak to actually hear with the human ear. If we could hear it, it would sound like a single steady note, playing constantly, but changing very slightly over time. Having decades ago visited the huge planets Jupiter and Saturn, Voyager 1 is now providing insight into interstellar space. The immense regions between star systems in a galaxy are not a complete vacuum. The stew of matter and radiation present in low densities, mostly gas, is called the interstellar medium. About 15% of the visible matter in our Milky Way galaxy is composed of this interstellar gas, dust, and energetic particles like cosmic rays. Much of the interstellar medium is in what is called an ionized or electrically charged state called plasma. Voyager 1 previously detected disturbances in the gas in interstellar space triggered by occasional flares from our sun. This study instead reveals the steady vibrations unrelated to solar activity that could be a constant feature in interstellar space. This hum has a frequency of about 3 kilohertz. Let's play it for you. Listen to the eerie sound of interstellar space. When the plasma oscillations are converted to an audio signal, it sounds like a tone that varies. It's a bit eerie, said Cornell University astronomy professor and study co-author James Cords. After 44 years of travel, Voyager 1 is the most distant human-made object in space. Voyager 1 will keep going, but its power supply will run out, most likely this decade, after up to 50 years of service, Cords said. There are conceptual designs being made for future probes whose intended purpose is to reach further than the Voyager spacecraft. Here's hoping the Voyager spacecrafts continue to operate as long as they can in the harsh environment of interstellar space. And who knows, someone somewhere out there might find it and discover our presence. It is terrifying and exciting at the same time, but only time will tell.